Are you looking for a somewhat compact, high wattage, foldable panel with MC4 connectors? Personally, I have been testing out a lot of EcoFlow panels over the years now and have been really happy with them. However, when you get a new solar generator and it's bundled with a 200 watt solar panel, you give it a try. So, compared to what I've experienced with EcoFlow panels, how does the Anker 200 watt solar panel hold up? I'm Wanderer 001. Let's get into it. One of the first things that I want to bring to your attention for the Anker over the EcoFlow panel is that one, Anker, you don't have a case for it. This is actually the solar panel itself. These are the legs of the solar panel to keep it up. There is a plastic carrying handle on two of the four solar panel segments themselves to kind of make it so that you can carry it. But I also want you to notice that, well, here are your connector cables that go right to your MC4 cable, and they're just kind of hanging out on the outside here. So unless you plan on unplugging these all the time, this is a little inconvenient to have because you can't really tuck them in because I'd be worried about damaging the panels themselves. But that's an observation that I wanted to show you while we were talking about the main difference of a carrying case versus not a carrying case. Since this doesn't have a carrying case, in its closed position, the Anker 200 watt solar panel is 21.9 inches tall, so just shy of 22 inches, and has a width of 23.9, again, just shy of 24, and is 2 inches in depth. So slightly smaller in depth than the Anker 220 watt panel that I tested alongside of this. Now, looking at the back of this panel itself, I can show you one of the bigger differences, and that is this here. This leg snaps in, and this is our adjuster here. This will allow us to adjust the angle of our panel using a snap. Using these, we can adjust from 30, 40, 50, or 80 degrees. And I like how it kind of holds things in place because there's this here and it's snapping in, kind of locking things in. You'll also notice that the legs themselves snap into place, but because this also does not have a carrying case, the innermost panels snap together, making it so that this kind of sticks together a little bit. It's not as good as I would like, but I just wanted to bring that to your attention. Overall, the panels also weigh 16.3 pounds, and that's partially due to some of the materialistic choices that were made in the design of the panel. If we take a look at one of our solar panel segments, the panel itself is IP67 weather rated. There also is a rubberized coating, which allows dust and water to move off of the solar panel itself much easier. But let me show you what this is like fully open. Filming today inside because, well, weather did not cooperate. So garage, still get the general idea. In its open state, the panel is 82 inches long, still has that height of 23.9. You will also notice here and over here, you could see the brackets for the kickstands in the back. It does not do all the solar segments. This one right here does not actually have a kickstand, which is a little meh in my opinion. The solar efficiency of the panel is up to 23%, meaning that the solar energy that the panels capture and then convert to usable electricity for your solar generator has a 23% efficiency rating, which is about standard and what you'd expect. But just because I'm filming this segment on a rainy day doesn't mean I didn't test this solar panel on actual bright sunny days. Let me show you what that was like.
200 watt Anker panel. It's about 160, sun right overhead.
Doing pretty good.
We're going to try and stick this into a Anker one. Apparently, I overloaded the River 2. It just couldn't take the input from it, which I thought was a little weird. So I got the big boy Delta here.
Anker SOLIX 200 watt panel, getting a maximum input of 156, 157, which is a little closer to what the EcoFlow 220 was getting in here. I don't know if it's because Anker's doing some under the hood magic or what with their own panel, but it didn't blow this one out or overload it. So, you know, compared to what input was for the Delta, it's okay. That's pretty good. You're getting a good conversion rate.
Getting 160, 162. Not really focusing, but
laying it flat. Sun's just about overhead on a perfectly clear day.
Coming around to the back, and I know this isn't the best viewing angle for that, but we're going to talk about the legs and why, instead of spinning this around and resetting up for the shoot, I just moved the camera around because these legs are a pain in the butt to set up. Yes, you get 30, 40, 50, or 80 degree angles that you can do with the preset buttons, but they're so thin, they're so floppy with this setup that it is a difficult operation to readjust these, especially since you also only have three legs and this middle one here doesn't have one. I don't know why companies that have four panel setups like this don't have like an extra leg to help make this a little easier to operate. You can also see over here that there are connections, and them being on the back of the panel instead of the front of the panel adds an extra layer of things to overcome, because when you're setting this up, the cable might end up underneath the solar panel, and then you have to fish it out, and then the leg will move and not be where you want it to be. So while in theory, having this all included is really good, I don't particularly like the legs. I know that it's better than not having anything here at all, and I know companies are still learning what works best, but this is not really doing it for me. In fact, most of the time I will just lean this up against a set of garbage cans or throw it flat on the ground so that it just gets the sun that way. Not saying that the legs are useless, but setting them up is more of a hassle than they're worth, in my opinion. With any solar panel, there are going to be pluses and minuses. So there are a few cons that I wanted to point out for the Anker 220W solar panel. First being, the legs feel very flimsy. Like, they really feel like they're just cardboard that was wrapped in fabric. And the fastening system, the buttons, just, there's a lot of buttons. There's a lot of things to worry about. It's not the greatest system in the world, in my opinion. Yes, I do enjoy the fact that they have these little breakouts in between the solar panels to help it not become a kite, but it still does get blown over in a stronger breeze. Second, the preset angles might not be enough to get the maximum amount of solar energy that you want. There are other options out there that allow you to do between 30 and 60 degrees and anywhere in between based on a slide. These are preset lock-ins. Granted, you could just lean this against something or throw it flat on a deck like I do most of the time in order to get the solar energy that you're looking for, but those presets are constraining. As I briefly mentioned, a stronger wind may blow it over even with those cutouts that allow air to pass through it. Again, I really like that idea and think other manufacturers, one in particular, could learn something from that. Last, as a con for me, is it weighs a lot more than even my higher 220-watt solar panel from another manufacturer. And the folding carrying mechanism for it is just, it's really janky. If the snaps on the inside panels don't work, it can accordion open on you. It's not the greatest. Yes, it cuts down on packaging and does help keep it to be a little cheaper than some of the competition. But because of that, it's just, you're gonna have to bungee it yourself or put something through the handles to keep everything together. That's just a data point for you to consider. With that in mind, if you're looking for a high watt, all-in-one portable solar panel for home or on the go, I still can recommend the Anker 200-watt solar panel with those caveats, as long as you know what you're getting into. And the fact that the legs in the back are more of a gimmick than anything else. But if this sounds like the solar panel you've been looking for, I will have a link where you could pick one up for yourself in the description area below. If you appreciate the time and effort that goes into making a comprehensive video like this, make sure to give it a thumbs up to help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here and want to be notified of my next review, hit that subscribe button. Still not sure if this is the right solar panel for you? On screen now, you'll see two other reviews that I've done to help you make a more informed decision for yourself.